So this year we have three positions available. One medical, we have five candidates that are going to court. Today we have Steve Miro, Scott Krieger, and Eric Klein. Jay Kelsey could not make it, and Tom Ciano, hope I didn't put your name on, I apologize, was unable to make it. His mother was having surgery and he's still at the hospital. So, but I think we can still have a good debate here with the three candidates are here. So we'll same rules apply. We'll start off with opening comments from Steve Miro, and you have 2 minutes for that.
Thanks, Mike.
You good? You got a good mic there?
You guys all hear me?
Yeah.
All right. Hey, everybody. My name is Steve Miro. I've lived in Rootstown since the year 2000. I have two kids, 14-year-old girl, freshman, and a 12-year-old boy, seventh grade. They're both very active at Rootstown sports, basketball, softball, baseball, football. I spent a lot of time coaching them in the variety of sports that they do. For me and my personal life, I'm part owner of a medical company located in Cleveland, so I do that for a full-time job. I really wanted to run for school board because I've spent such an active role in my kids' lives on the sporting side of things, and I really want to spend a more active role in their education. And so I started looking at the school board, and that's why I decided to enter the candidacy for Board of Education. Short and sweet.
Good evening, I'm Scott Krieger. I'm a candidate for Rootstown School Board. First, I would like to thank Mr. Zabo for putting this event together. I think it's a great opportunity for everyone to kind of learn who's playing in Rootstown. I'd also like to thank NeoMed for providing the venue for us today, so thank you very much. I'm a 1992 graduate of Rootstown. My mother retired from the district as a middle school librarian. I have three children, ages 8, 11, and 13, all in the district. I've been married to my wife, Sarah, for 14 years. I lived in Rootstown most of my life. I've been involved in the community, mostly coaching softball, baseball, and basketball for the last 9 years. I am a police officer at the Ravenna Police Department and been there for 23 years. I served as president of the Ravenna Police Association for 4 years and currently serve as a trustee on the board. I've been asked, why do you want to be on the school board? Actually, it was more weird, why would you want to be on the school board? I've told people the school board may be the most important part, even more important than the trustees right now, as the direction in which the school goes will affect the rest of the town. A quick story about me. We recently built a pole building on our property. Having the size of the building in mind, hampered by our budget, I did what I do best. I found siding, poles, insulation, floor heating system all on Craigslist. I repurposed steel light poles taken down from the old party's parking lot. My garage doors came from a building slated for demolition. After a little work and a little paint, you never know that the doors are not new. I've been called cheap, but I'd like to think that I'm resourceful. Now, I'm not suggesting that we build new schools or fix the ones we have using materials scavenged from Craigslist or Facebook Marketplace. I truly believe that as your school member, I will offer a unique and different way to look at things and make Rootstown schools the best it can be. The community can no longer kick the can down the road nothing about the condition of our aging classrooms, but I do not think that the school levy as proposed is right for Rootstown. Thank you.
Good evening. My name is Eric Klein. I want to thank everybody for attending this evening. I see a lot of familiar faces out in the crowd and a lot of new faces. Hopefully in the years to come I get to meet most of you guys in the room today. I want to thank Mr. Zabo again and NeoMed, Mr. Krieger's Thunder there for having this today. To start off, I'll speak about myself and my family. I'm a 1995 graduate of Ravenna. I was big into athletics at the Ravenna School District. I was on the wrestling team throughout the 90s, played baseball. I was raised by a single dad. I have a wife of 16 years, Rachel. We have three children. Mason is 14, he's a freshman. Our daughter Aubrey's a seventh grader at the middle school. And Ben, our young one, is a 10-year-old. He's a fifth grade at the elementary. I coached baseball at Ravenna and here at Woodstown combined for approximately 10 years for my kids, my daughter, Logan. I also coached for the youth wrestling programs in both school districts for the last 10 years at Ravenna and at Woodstown. By the way, you guys have a great wrestling program here. I'm employed with AT&T, the phone company. As some of you guys may know, it's the old Ohio Bell. I've been there for 17 years, going on 17 years, 12 years as a lineman. Last 5 years, I've been in management. I've managed anywhere between 15 to 20 linemen. So that's pretty much been my primary job the last 5 years at the phone company. Reasons why I'm running for school, or I decided to run for school board. Again, I mentioned I have three kids. This is a great community since we moved here. We moved here approximately 4 years ago. I love it here at Woodstown. I absolutely love it. So I'm looking forward to hoping for your vote and becoming a part of this great school district.
I've been in the township for my entire life, 66 of my 70 years, and each time these positions come up for election, I tend to see the members become, the candidates become more active in their approach. This year, up until within the last 48 hours, I had no idea who the hell you guys are. Why haven't you done anything more proactive, more aggressive to expose yourself and your justification for wanting this secondary position in your life, which is, for me, very important?
It's equally as awkward to be the first one to answer. Yeah, when it comes to, you know, I go to a lot of the sporting events, community events. I've been to the summer fest we had, a lot of the football events. So I try to get myself out there a little bit as much as I can. To be completely honest with you, the reason I did not do any signs this year is because my budget just didn't allow it. And maybe that's what the school board needs. Maybe we need to spend money a little more wisely on things that are important. I had offers for people to support my campaign. I turned them down. I wanted just to do it by myself. And I'm glad I made that choice. Thank you.
Part of the reason I'm not a politician, so I kind of find it hard sometimes to, go out and talk to people. Door to door, vote for me. I do have a couple signs out there. I'm still working on a couple more, but I'm painting them myself. I haven't paid a company to print them up for me, so you'll see a few more coming up. But just, I have three kids, and life happens. Part of it was, the budget. I didn't want to go out and spend a whole lot of money. But for the most part, I just, my mom and dad made a good name for us in this community, and I think that, a lot of it, I hope that, they recognize my name and the good things that my parents did, and, raised three children, and hopefully word of mouth. So hopefully tonight you guys all go out and tell everybody what a nice guy I am.
Again, I also have to steal a little bit of thunder from Scott Krieger over here. Again, I'm not a politician either, guys, ladies and gentlemen. I'm not. I'm just a dad with three kids, been married for 16 years, and I just want to be involved in the community one way or another. Now, I don't have all the answers to every question that maybe some of you guys may have. All three of us here are new. We've never ran for an elected position in our lives. But to answer your question, sir, I do have signs out there. They're blue and white. They're Kline, K-L-I-N-E, just like most of the Ritztown clients here, they're K-L-I-N-E. So I'm out there. Maybe I just got to get bigger letters on my signs or get bigger billboards, but Mr. Krieger brought all the plywood at Carter Lumber. But I'm promoting it, so I hope that answers your question.
Hi, I'm Lori Moranzi again, and I was not pointed enough with my questions to the trustees as they were outstanding at being elusive. So I'm going to put a little bit more pointed to you three. Share with me why or why not you would give up 41% from the Ohio Facilities Commission to build new schools for our students.
Thanks, Lori, for the question. You may want to ask Mogador Schools why they did not use the state. When you use state funding, there's a lot of stipulations that come with that, right down to the type of carpet that you have to use in your auditorium, and different aspects that a lot of districts really wouldn't want to put in their building, but they have to because of the state mandates. If you talk to, I believe, the Southeast School District, they did use state funding, and I have heard that they would not do it again. When you use your own money, you can do what you want with that money, and you don't have to worry about the state telling you what to put in your building and what you cannot put in your building.
I think each school district that, in my opinion, that has taken state money has their own issues that they're dealing with, whether it be Wyndham, Southeast, Mogador. My wife and I and the kids, we lived in Ravenna at the time. They built a brand new high school. That was a nice building that they built there. I voted for that levy. I thought it was the right choice to make. I don't regret voting for that, but for the schools of Ritztown, I think there might be some things that we can trim some fat off what's being proposed on this levy right now as it stands. But again, there is a nice incentive when you have 41% being paid for by the state of Ohio. But again, that's why you guys go to the polls to vote. But other than that, that's all I have.
As a business owner, it seems like a really hard proposal to turn down. I have not made my decision yet on how I'm voting for the levy, but I'm leaning for it because the last thing I want to see is this to be delayed another 4 years, 8 years, 12 years. If my kids are in the school right now, and I don't know if they'll be able to see a new building or not, but I may have grandkids in the schools, and I would just hate to put it off any further. So I really do believe now is the time. And as we go through the process, I think we can figure out a lot of specifics.
Hi, I'm Aubrey Burl, fifth grade teacher at the elementary school. And I'm assuming, because you're all running, that you are interested in all the children's well-being. My hopes are that, at least. But I just want to know, what's your main motive for running? What is your main intention? What are you hoping to accomplish if you are voted in?
The main purpose why I ran, basically, in a nutshell, is to be the voice of my kids and your guys' kids. Again, in my opening statement, I made a comment that I know a lot of familiar faces in the crowd today. Being a member of the school board, it would be a great opportunity to speak for you guys. The other thing, too, is you have three young guys here on the board. All three of us, we're new to the board that we're running for. We're not being reelected. So you have a lot of, you have three guys up here with, basically with new blood. And I think that'd be a great opportunity for a school district. Again, I mentioned that I coach youth sports. I just really enjoy the kids. I have a soft spot for kids. And again, I think just having some young faces on the school board would be a good positive thing for us.
Hey, Joe, before we forget, this gentleman was trying to ask a question for the trustees like all night, and he's had his hand up for us all night too. Can you make sure you hit him? All right, thanks. Aubrey, thanks for the question. Again, I'm kind of like these guys, kind of new at this. Decided to run for this position because of my kids being in the school and in the community. And a few meetings that I've been to have just seemed to be a little redundant, very status quo, very machine-like. And I hope to bring a source of innovation, maybe new ideas, maybe new thoughts, thinking a little outside of the box to what hopefully will be a new school board.
The reason that I had run or started, or when I first decided that I was going to run, the school board was still deciding, you know, if they were going to stay put, if they were going to consider moving. I was always for the option of staying where they are. I did not want to see a school built elsewhere. And then, you know, then came the topic of the levy. As my opening statements, I don't think that we need to build all new schools. I think the high school is in great shape. There could be some updates to it. I know it needs to be ADA compliant. But the main reason is physical structure, and I would like to be a part of that and make sure that our kids are in buildings that are safe and that are best for them, shaping their future.
Thank you. Not in the back room. No, I mean from the standpoint of getting. I wish the other two candidates were here because I am not sold on the three that I'm looking at, making the observation that you're running for a school board when the current school needs are saying we have to change. We have to build buildings. There are no buildings in what, a fifth decade? And you have a 100-year-old building. Now, you made an observation that state monies have strings attached to it. And one of the local school districts turned down that opportunity after they failed the levy with the state's support money. They passed the second time. But they haven't passed an operating levy in over 25 years. So this negativism in supporting schools and other issues in communities, it falls back on the taxpayer and nobody else. So it's an easy thing to say, I can't go anymore. But the value of your community is measured by the value of your school. Rustown isn't going to stay as it is today. So putting our head in the sand as to development, growth, all we can do is attempt to control. But I would expect people running for school board at this time would tell me at this time, I am supporting this issue. We have to move ahead and I'm going to be part of the process. If you're going to be neutral or negative, you know, we need some direction and leadership. I'm new to this community, having come from the previous. We've already gone through building schools. This township needs it as well. So that's where I stand. I'm not impressed yet. I think you all have probably good motives. You want to be on the school board, but you haven't sold me.
You have a specific question?
And I'm not trying to criticize you. I'm just saying.
You have a specific question?
Lance. Thanks for being here tonight. I have a fairly simple question. In all of the information that I've read about the levy and the new schools, I certainly understand all about the new stadium, the new track, the new weightlifting room, all that kind of stuff. What I haven't seen is what do you or this, and I know the current school board's not here, but what do you see needs to be in the building where the kids are actually going to learn how to be adults for tomorrow? Can you tell me what two things each of you thinks needs to be part of what's inside that school where the kids will be learning to be the leaders of Rootstown 20 years from now?
That's a really good question. I don't know if I'm going to give you a good answer either. I don't really understand enough about what the school board controls as far as curriculum goes. I'm sure there's some standards through the state that they have to follow. All I know is my kids complain about Common Core just about every night of the week. But I'm probably going to just skirt the question because I don't know enough to give you a good answer. But I intend to find out.
I don't believe it's a new building is what makes a good school system. I think what's in it as far as administrators, teachers, and students that want to learn. St. Ignatius was built in 1891, and it's still used today, and it ranks in the top five across the state of Ohio as a high school, either parochial or public schools. So it's not the buildings, I believe it's the teachers and the administration.
So, if I remember your question correctly, what two things that would help the children to become young adults, was that your question?
Or old adults.
Older adults, whatever. Get them ready for adulthood, basically. Whether we like this or not, the one thing that does change in life is technology. Technology constantly changes. Again, I mentioned I graduated back in 1995. We didn't have iPhones, and the internet was just coming out. And I think the technology to get these kids prepared for the years ahead, going into their starting their own businesses or going into new companies or coming out of college, we got to get them ready for their adult years, mainly the college side of it. The one thing that I notice with young children today is leadership. Now, I'm not saying that a young 10-year-old has to be a leader on a football field or a wrestling mat or a baseball field, but today's kids, for some reason, that leadership quality seems to be lacking in the younger children, even the high school kids. So I think if we can focus on that, and try to hold our kids accountable to be good parents, and it starts in the home. I think those are the two things that make kids successful for adults.
Hi, I'm Stacy. I am an educator in a top performing district. I've been in Rootstown for about 10 years now, and I have kids in the building, so I'm hugely invested in school. My question to you would be, aside from your knowledge of athletics in the community, which we all very much appreciate and participate in, what can you talk about or tell us about 21st century learning? I know that you mentioned technology. What research have you read, if any? And what do you know about the progression, and to piggyback on what he said about where we need to be, regardless of what building we're in?
I have not, and I think that's where your curriculum advisor or your curriculum person in charge of that will take care of that. I mean, I don't know if as a school board member, if you know you're to set curriculum, and I would agree with Mr. Klein that technology is important. I don't think that has to come with a new school, but I do agree that
Same thing would apply with myself. Again, all three of us being new people willing to throw our hat in the ring for school board, we have a lot to learn. It's not like we're 4 years into this and we're in front of a re-election. So I'm not trying to dodge a question, Miss, I'm not. But again, like I said in my previous comment, I'm just a real firm believer when it comes to our children, it's just holding this accountable and starts in the home with the parents. And again, like I mentioned before, that's just something that we have to learn as candidates. And if we're not willing to learn that, then we shouldn't be here doing this job. Most of us here at the table kind of threw our hat in the ring towards later when the board was announcing the candidates or the candidate availability. So I'm not going to blow smoke. I'm just going to be honest with you. We've got a little ways to go.
Unfortunately, I'll have to echo what these guys said as well. I guess it comes down to curriculum and then educators like yourself. I can remember going through school. There's certain teachers that I remember, and it wasn't really the subject they taught, but it was how they taught it. And I know my kids feel the same way. They still have their favorite teachers, and whether it was because they used the electronic board that the schools had or whether it was technology, I think a lot of it comes down to the people that are relaying the information to the kids and how they react to them and how they respond to those educators.
Hi, my name is Nancy Nichols. I just want to come to the defense of these three men sitting in front of me. At one point, I was in your place. I served 14 years on the Board of Education in Ritztown, and I think that some of the questions that they ask, you don't know anything about, and it's not because you're not informed, you haven't been there yet. And after you get elected, you will learn all of the necessary things that you have to do as a school board member. So I just want to come to your defense. I know that you don't know everything. God knows you don't, because after 14 years, I still didn't know everything. But I just want to say, answer the best way you can. If you don't know, just say so. We will understand. I will understand anyway.
Evening, gentlemen. My name is Mike Kerrigan, and I want to thank you for coming and presenting yourself as candidates before us tonight. It's a big step to hop into public service, and I appreciate your attempt. My question is, we're sitting in the same building as one of the top 20 ranked public high schools in the state of Ohio. And I'm wondering to get the three of your opinion on the relationship with the STEM school and the Ritztown Local School District. Do you see it, being in the same township, do you see it as an opportunity for the school district, or do you see it as a more of a challenge for the school?
Can you repeat that last sentence there?
Sure. Do you see the being co-located in the same township with the STEM school, do you see it as a challenge or an opportunity for the Ritztown Local School District?
I think it'd be an opportunity. Anything that we do in life is always an opportunity that you gotta take. I kind of put challenges in with an opportunity. They kind of go together, in my opinion. So to answer your question, I see it as an opportunity.
I agree wholeheartedly. It's definitely an opportunity. I think the challenge is just how we can all work together and understand that certain kids are going to need certain needs or want different things, and that's okay. As long as we can find a way to work and live together, obviously, then it's by far and away an opportunity.
I would agree with both, too. It is an opportunity. I mean, from a parent standpoint, what a great opportunity if one of my children decide that that's what they want to do. Problem with that, sitting on a school board, from what I understand, Ritztown loses money when a child goes to BioMed. So from that aspect, I think you have to, as a board member, make it more inviting for them children to stay in their local school district, if that's what you want to do. But
Darren Beatty, very quick question. I'm wondering how many school board meetings you each attended in the last year and then in the last 5 years.
My number would be the same. So it was three, and I started attending the school board meetings once I decided to throw my hat in the ring to be a candidate.
I've been to the last two. Prior to that, it was a few years ago. So
same here. Like I mentioned in my opening statement, my wife and I and the kids, we recently moved here about 3 years ago, started getting involved with the schools and meeting new people. I was encouraged to run by a lot of friends and people I met in the community. Again, same with these gentlemen here, probably the last three within this year. Diane, I can actually speak to your question. My wife and I, we actually sold our house in Ravenna Township, and we lived with her, my mother and father-in-law in Hiram, for a brief stint. We were looking to purchase a home somewhere in Ritztown, so we opened and enrolled our three kids here. Probably one of the best decisions I ever made for our three kids. Not only was it just for the academics and the teachers, but the community in general. We really love it down here. It was a great opportunity for our kids to come down. So I'm for it. The thing that we gotta focus on though is we do have smaller classroom sizes and smaller buildings. So we gotta make sure that the head count equals what we have on staff. So we wanna make sure that we don't get too overcrowded, but we gotta make sure we find that balance and be smart about it.
Diane, you looking out there better or down here? Me too. I would exactly agree with what Eric said. I'm all for it. I think it's great for kids that want to come and get an education here at Ritztown. A lot of times the families follow anyway if they're not here yet, which is great for the community. But again, as long as we're not outgrowing the classroom size or the buildings and we keep everything within range of ratio, then
my name is Nikki Mills, and I moved here 12 years ago with my family. And the community, I love that this town is like a small country community, but we need to grow. Not just the town, but the schools need to grow. We are so far behind in other schools with technology, clubs. I mean, sports is wonderful here, but what about the kids that don't do sports? We have no kind of robotics club, Lego club, chess club, anything that interests those children. What do you plan on doing for them?
That was actually one of the first things that I noticed when we moved here was there's no ski club. There's no little school that I came from that I mentioned before. We had some things that we could do extracurricular-wise, but I've noticed that we don't have a handful of those that we could do here at Ritztown. Now, I'm not sure how the hiring and the firing goes with staff and coaches and who does what first, but I'm sure with the union, I would assume that teachers would get first dibs on becoming a coach for the ski club if you want to invent a ski club or a Lego club. If not, the look for volunteers, look for people that want to become part of the community and part of the school district, that want to volunteer their time to coach after school hours. That's my suggestion. Yes, I'm all for it. Whatever we can do to keep the kids active, motivated, being engaged, bring them down, get them involved in sports.
I think that's something we definitely need to look into. And a matter of fact, at the last school board meeting, a high school principal had mentioned a tech club that had started, and it has evolved into a robotics club. And I thought that was pretty awesome. I didn't know anything about that, so maybe that's the start of a very good trend that we could have with some other ski clubs and I mean, Lego club. Great idea.
My 13-year-old son would love to be in a Lego club. Yeah, I mean, I think the more you can offer students, I mean, I'm not of the opinion that sports are everything. Very outside, even after high school, very few kids will move on and pursue sports beyond high school. So I think, preparing children for things other than sports is what we should be doing. I think sports are good in high school as far as team building and teaching kids winning attitudes that just evolve into other things as you move along in life. So yes, I mean, clubs, and if elected, I will